Hey everyone, I hope you all are safe and happy in these recent stressful times. Let's just take all the stress out of our minds and dump it into the analysis. Today, we will be performing a static structural analysis with three-dimensional tetra meshing. We will be simulating an automobile knuckle in various loading conditions. The link for the CAD model is provided in the description. I recommend that you download the file and follow this tutorial step by step to get a better understanding of the overall process. To explain every step in detail, I have divided this tutorial into two parts. In the first part, we will be doing the geometry editing and the 3D tetra mesh generation. In the second part, we'll talk about the second part later. Let's get right into it. To perform a static structural analysis, we will be using the OptiStruct solver. We will start by selecting the user profile as OptiStruct. It is possible to change the user profile at any point during the setup process by using the user profile button in the ribbon. The commonly used CAD formats are IGES and STEB. But in the latest versions of HyperMesh, we can directly import the geometry from commercial CAD software like SolidWorks and CATIA V5. We can change the name and color of our component in the model browser. As we will be using the same component to create our mesh, we will set it as the current component. The first step is to delete all the solids using the delete panel. It can be accessed by using the key F2. We cannot edit geometry surfaces when they are bounded to a solid. After deleting the internal solids, we can perform geometry editing and simplification on the surfaces. Now we will create a 2D mesh on all the surfaces, which will later be converted into a 3-dimensional tetra mesh. With element size as 8, I will use mesh type as R-trias. R-trias are used when we want to capture geometry features like curves and fillets accurately. Now we will create a 3-dimensional tetra mesh using these 2D elements. Select the knuckle component in fixed trias/quads to tetra mesh. With type as simple pyramid, create the mesh. For tetra elements, the tet collapse is the most crucial element quality criteria. The mesh we created right now is not satisfactory with nearly 800 elements failing in tet collapse. Head back to the tetra mesh panel. We will fix the quality of our 3D elements. Select tet collapse from the list of quality checks. For this simulation, we will set the threshold at 0.3. The industry standard value is usually 0.6 or above. With maximum iterations as 5, click on Show Failed. Now we will fix the quality of these elements automatically. Observe that two elements are still failing. We will now edit these elements manually. Tet collapse is the measure of comparability of three dimensions of an element. The value of tet collapse can be increased by increasing the height of the element. Let's start by saving the two elements that are failing in tet collapse. Using the mask panel, that is F5, we will isolate these elements. Now, to distinguish the corner nodes of these elements, we will add temporary nodes at these locations. We will increase the height of these elements manually. Press Shift F4 to open the Translate panel. With selection box on nodes, select the node which we want to translate to increase the height of the element. Define the normal plane using the other three nodes as N1, N2 and N3. Specify an arbitrary magnitude and translate in the desired direction. You can check the value of Tet Collapse by opening the Element Quality panel and clicking on the element. After getting a satisfactory value, clear the temporary nodes and mask the element to avoid confusion while editing other elements. The Distance panel can be used to change the distance between any two nodes. Manual mesh editing is not a scripted process. There is no fixed number of steps to get the perfect mesh. It is completely iterative. You have to decide the steps based on your own intuition. It is a skill which can only be developed by continuous practice. Sometimes editing one element may cause another one to fail. It is necessary to have patience and keep making required adjustments. I can only teach the various features in HyperMesh to edit mesh elements. Finally, to use them and create a good mesh is completely up to you. We have achieved a satisfactory Tet Collapse value for all the elements in our geometry. Remember that we created 2D elements in the beginning. It is necessary to delete them so that our component contains only 3-dimensional elements. This can be done using the configuration option in Delete panel. As we have created our Traya elements, their configuration is Traya 3. Our mesh is now ready to be used in the simulation. We will save our model in a separate folder. Remember to use an underscore in place of space while saving the file to avoid errors when we run the simulation. This completes the first part of this video. In the second part, we'll actually apply the constraints, forces, torques, and then actually run the simulation. I will be posting the second part shortly. Until then, like, share, and subscribe to AeroSwap. Hit the notification bell to stay updated.